So, okay children, so far we have discussed about the different types of solids like crystalline, amorphous, ionic, molecular, covalent, etc. The lattice of the solids, the unit cells, its types, the number of atoms, packing in two dimensions, three dimensions, density of solids, etc. So, all these topics we have already discussed in the previous classes. So today in this class, we will be talking about the defects or imperfections in solids, right? So each solid is having some defects in it. Now, why do the solids, they have defects? Now, what is the meaning of defect first? Let us talk about that one first. Now, according to the third law of thermodynamics, a solid said to possess zero entropy at zero Kelvin. It means according to the third law, we can say a crystalline solid possesses zero entropy at zero Kelvin. Or we can say the entropy of a perfectly crystalline substance is zero at zero Kelvin. What does it mean? That only at zero Kelvin, we can have an ordered regular arrangement of the points in the lattice of a solid. Means only at zero Kelvin we can talk about the actual structure of the solid. But it is not possible to take the solid to zero Kelvin, which is theoretically impossible to attain. So every time practically impossible to attain. So it is very difficult to talk about the exact ordered arrangement. So since the crystal is always above zero Kelvin because of the difference in the temperature, because of the heat gained by the particles, certain particles they are missing from their regular lattice sites. I have told you the importance of each lattice point. Each lattice point represents an atom or a molecule or the ion and its space in the three dimensions. So that is a fixed point for a particular atom, molecule or ion in the lattice of the solid. But when I say the temperature is not zero Kelvin, it is above zero Kelvin. Now, as the temperature is more than zero Kelvin, the lattice points are missing. They are not there at their regular lattice site. Like in a class, when you sit on your respective seats, we say the class is an ordered class. But some of you may leave the seat, you go to another classroom, you go to washroom, you go to have water. Then we say there is randomness in the class or disorder in the class. So we say there is entropy in the class. So these solids, they also possess entropy above zero Kelvin, right? So when the points or the atoms or the ions or the molecules, they are missing from their regular lattice site, we say there are imperfections or defects in the solid. So we say a solid said to possess its regular ordered structure only at zero Kelvin, when certain points are missing from the regular lattice sites, it leads to the defects or imperfections in the solid. I suppose I am clear with the meaning of imperfections. So why do we have imperfection or what is a defect? When points are missing, when atoms are missing, from when molecules are missing from their regular lattice sites. Now why do the crystals, they have defects? The point is, why don't they possess an ordered structure? Why do they have the defects? Now these defects, they arise due to the change in temperature. When the temperature is more, the kinetic energy of the particle is more, they overcome the forces of attraction between them and they may leave their regular lattice site. 12th A ka bachcha 12th B mein baith gaya, 12th B ka bachcha 12th C mein baith gaya. This is all we call defect in a particular class or defect in the lattice of the solid. So the role of these defects is, because of these defects, the conductivity of the solids increases. Those solids which said to be insulators at zero Kelvin becomes conductors. They start conducting electric current, they start conducting heat because of the defects in the solids. So this point we discuss a little later, that how do they become conductor from insulators. So these defects are there to modify the properties of the solid, but up to a certain extent these defects are permissible. If these defects are more in number, the lattice of the solid may collapse. So up to a certain degree, these defects are useful for the solids. Otherwise, they result in the collapsing of the lattice of the solid. Now we say these defects are there in the solids, and these defects are known as, they are also known as thermodynamic defects, because they are there because of the change in the temperature. Now we are going to classify these defects as point defects, line defects, and plane defects. point defects. Now, what is the meaning of point defect? Now, suppose I have a regular lattice. See, if I have a regular lattice, these circles, they represent the lattice points. So, this is a regular lattice. When you have this type of arrangement, this is a regular lattice and this is possible only when the temperature is 0 Kelvin. Above 0 Kelvin, what we see is this, that this point is missing from this place. Instead of circle, I am drawing these squares. These squares, they show that the regular points are missing. The points are missing from their regular lattice site. Now, the points are randomly missing. Koi yahan se utke chala gaya, koi row 1 se, koi row 2 se, koi last row se. So, these points are randomly missing. There is not a particular fashion, not a particular order of missing of these atoms or the molecules. So, such type of defect where the points are randomly missing from their regular lattice sites, they are known as point defects. But in this figure, you see the points are missing successively from a line. They are successively missing from a row. So when the points are missing successively from a line or from a row, we call this type of defect as line defect. This line defect is also known as dislocation. Dislocation is the other name given to the line defect. Now, if you see this figure, now you can see the points are missing from a plane. This is not a line. This is not randomly missing of the points from a plane, a two-dimensional plane. Certain points are missing. So, this type of defect, when the points are missing from a plane, it is called a plane defect. And these plane defects are very rare. The most common type of defects are the point defects. So, in this chapter, we will mainly talking about the point defects. The line defect is only for the definition. You may get the definition for 1 mark. What is dislocation point? Plane defects are not even mentioned in the NCERT. But just for the sake of the knowledge that they are also there. But in rare cases, we find the plane defects. We mostly have point defect and somewhere we have the line defects as well. So, we'll continue with the point defects. Now, these point defects are the thermodynamic defects. And these point defects, they are of two types. We may have stoichiometric point defects or non-stoichiometric point defects. Now, what is the meaning of stoichiometry? A stoichiometric compound is the one. Suppose we have NaCl, the example of sodium chloride. In sodium chloride, when we write the formula of sodium chloride, it is Na plus Cl minus. Means this Na plus and Cl minus are in 1:1 ratio. So, when the ratio of the sodium and the chloride ion remains the same as given by its chemical formula, even after the defect, then the defect is said to be a stoichiometric defect. Stoichiometry means the ratio should be same as given by the chemical formula. So, if the defect is not disturbing the ratio of the positive and negative ion, then that type of defect is called stoichiometric defect. So, the number of positive and negative ion remains in the same ratio as given by its chemical formula. Even after the defect, it is stoichiometric. I have given you the example Na plus Cl minus. Even after the defect, if the ratio remains 1:1, we say it is stoichiometric defect. But if the ratio gets disturbed, if the ratio is not same as given by the chemical formula, then the defect is said to be a non-stoichiometric defect. So there may be chances that the number of sodium ions are more than that of chloride ion, or number of chloride ions are more than that of sodium ion. So the ratio gets disturbed. It is not same as given by its chemical formula. It is a non-stoichiometric defect. Now these stoichiometric defects are further classified as vacancy defect and interstitial defect or impurity defect. Now, vacancy defect first. Vacancy defect means, as the name vacancy suggests, there are vacancies in the lattice. When the points are missing, they lead to the formation of vacancies or holes in the lattice. Vacancies, like if a cation is missing from the regular lattice, like suppose if you see this structure A plus, B minus, A plus, this is an ionic solid of the type AB. AB mein se kya dikh raha hai? Like this, at this point, A plus should be there. But A plus is missing. So, when it is missing, there is a vacancy created. Vacancy means this is a place for A plus. It is not there. So, a vacancy is created in place of A plus. Since this is created at the place of a positive ion, this vacancy is also known as a positive hole. Vacancies or hole are the same things. A cationic vacancy is known as a positive hole. A negative vacancy is known as anionic hole. A negative hole or anionic hole, anionic vacancy or negative hole is the same thing. Cationic vacancy or a positive hole is the same thing. So I hope I am clear with the meaning of hole or the vacancy. Like the places, the space which is left is called a hole or a vacancy. So in vacancy defect, we have to study two different types of defects. Okay, first let me make it clear what is the interstitial defect. So vacancy defect, when there is formation of vacancies or holes in the lattice. While interstitial defect is the one when some impurity atoms are present in the interstitial voids of the lattice. Impurity atoms, like suppose I have a crystal of iron. Mere paas iron ka crystal tha. So I have the atoms of iron, iron, iron everywhere. Now if I dope this iron with some amount of carbon, so those carbon atoms, they go and occupy the interstitial spaces. So yahan par jo lattice points hai, even if they are missing, we are not talking about these points here. We are looking for if some impurity atoms, if some foreign atoms are present in the interstitial voids. So if some foreign atoms are present, they are treated as the impurities present in the lattice. This type of defect is known as interstitial defects. Again, this is done to modify the properties. Like iron has the tendency to get rusted. To modify this property that iron should not rust, we add some amount of carbon to it. We add some nickel to it. So that carbon nickel goes and occupy the interstitial spaces. So this interstitial defect is to be carried out to modify the properties of some of the solids. So interstitial defect means it is not a vacancy defect, right? It is different from the vacancy defect. Now, to continue with the vacancy defect, these vacancy defects are of two types. One is Schottky defect, another is Frankel defect. Schottky defect first. Now, in Schottky defect, a pair of ion, please class, you keep noting down the important points what I am telling you in this class. Like these two are very, very, very important topics. You always get one or the other question in your final exam in terms of MCQs, short notes, whatever. But the examiner must touch the one who sets the paper must touch these vacancy defects like Schottky, Frankel, interstitial, metal excess, metal deficient. So you please note down the important points what I am telling you in this class. So Schottky defect is the one we are taking these defects in ionic solids. So again I have an ionic solid of the type A plus B minus. So A plus B minus, A plus B minus. This is the arrangement that a positive ion is surrounded by negative ions and a negative ion is surrounded by a number of positive ions. So if you see in this lattice, in this particular structure, a pair of ion is missing. A pair of ion means a positive ion and a negative ion constitute one pair. So this is the place for A plus, this is the place for B minus. So from this lattice of AB, one A plus and one B minus is missing. So we say a pair of ion is missing from the lattice. So when equal number of positive and negative ions are missing from the lattice, that type of defect is known as Schottky defect. So what is Schottky defect? When a pair of ion is missing from regular lattice site. So yahan par number of positive holes are same as that of number of negative holes. One cation, one anion makes a pair, they are missing, leading to the formation of a positive hole and a negative hole in the lattice. Now when we talk about these defects, bachche, we have to study the definition. What is Schottky defect? When a pair of ion is missing from the regular lattice site. What type of crystals give these defects? The crystals where the size of cation and anion is comparable. Comparable means they have almost same sizes, not identical, but more or less their sizes are same. Such crystals, they give Schottky defect. So what is the condition for a crystal to show Schottky defect? That their ions, they must have comparable sizes. So second point, first the definition, then the condition, what type of crystals, where the size of cation and anion is comparable, and third thing is the consequences. What are the consequences of the Schottky defect? Now see, when we say the pair of ions are missing from the lattice, means some mass is missing. So because of the Schottky defect, there is decrease in the density of the crystal. The Schottky defect affects the density of the crystal. It decreases the density. So name the defect which decreases the density of the crystal. That is Schottky defect, right? The second consequence is it increases the conductivity of the solid. Conductivity aapko dikh raha hai kaise badh rahi hai? Now see, when A plus is missing, toh yahan A plus ka vacancy create ho gaya. This A plus can go and take its place. Yahan par vacancy aa jayega. Another A plus can come and take this place. So as a result, because of these positive holes, the movement of ions start in the lattice. One ion can move and takes the positive hole. Another, yahan pe hole create ho gaya. This hole will be taken up by another A plus. So positive hole will be taken up by another cation. Negative hole will be taken up by another anion. So because of the formation of this hole, yahan par B minus hai, so this B minus will occupy this and a hole will be created here. So this is how these hole moves, this is how the ions moves in the lattice, and because of the movement of ions in the lattice, the conductivity of the solid increases. So it increases the conductivity. Increased conductivity to hamesha hi hogi, whatever type of defect we have, but it decreases the density at the same time. This is the main consequence of the Schottky defect. Now, so first is definition, second is the condition, third is the consequences, and fourth one is you have to write the example. Now, examples mein yahan par what type of crystals gives the Schottky defect, where the sizes are comparable, and the examples are alkali metal halides. Alkali metal halides, you may have KCl, you may have KBr, you may have NaCl. All these crystals, they show Schottky defect. Many mentioned for the AgBr. This AgBr is taken as an exception because this AgBr is the only compound which gives Schottky defect as well as the Frenkel defect. So we may get for 1 mark, name the compound which gives Schottky as well as Frenkel defect. So that is AgBr, silver bromide. Now next is Frenkel defect. Now before taking the Frenkel defect, let me tell you one thing, that when we talk about the ionic solids, we know the size of the anion is always larger than the cations. Anion is bigger in size than the cation. So if anion is bigger, it always forms the lattice and cations will occupy the voids. If I am drawing like this, it is not exactly the same. These anions are forming the lattice and cations are present in the voids. Cations are present in the interstitial voids. It may be tetrahedral.